Good morning, my class 10 student. We are doing actually electromagnetism chapter from the month of April. Today we will discuss the last part of the chapter, that is electric generator. In the whole chapter we have studied so many things. The chapter is quite big, so after completion of this thing I am going to solve the worksheet of this video, and that will be uploaded soon, and then a short revision of this chapter. Clear? Because this chapter is quite big chapter. So already in my past video we had discussed Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, Lenz's law, Fleming's left hand rule, right hand thumb rule, so many things. So the last part of the chapter was electromagnetic induction. What was that? Electromagnetic induction is that when there is no electric current source in the circuit. There is no current source in the circuit. Okay. Now, if there is no current source, there is no chances of current flow through the circuit. Now, the thing is that if there is a changing magnetic field surrounded the circuit, so the magnetic flux which is passes through the coil or the circuit may be increased or decreased depending on the velocity and the direction of the magnetic field. Clear? Now, if the flux is changing, it is seen that there is a generation of electromotive force or current. Means there is a generation of voltage or current in the circuit where there is no physical existence of electric source. Clear? So, actually by induction effect, electromagnetic induction, by magnetic induction, electric force generated. That's why it is called electromagnetic induction. Actually, the electric power generator, what we are using when there is no current flow or something, I'm not talking about inverter. I'm talking about generator. Normally, what we are using normal days. So that generator is basically either a alternating current generator or direct current generator. Remember that. That is actually a electromagnetic induction generator. Means there is a changing magnetic field. For that changing magnetic field, electricity generated. That electricity will be used by us. So, in this video or today's discussion will be completely on electric generator. So, electric generator are basically two types. Number one, AC generator. Another one, DC generator. Both the generator has separate uses, but if I am telling the mother generator, means what was invented earlier, or which one is the easy to understand, that will be the AC generator. So first my discussion will be go through AC generator, then I will give you the glimpses of DC generator. Then I will go for the discussion, where is the distinction between these two, why, what is AC current, what is DC current. See, what is AC current, what is DC current, in class so you had asked me so many times, I had told you that time also, but here in a concise manner, I will tell you what is actually AC current, what is actually DC current, what are the difference between that. Why AC current is has so many application with respect to the DC current. So, we are going for all the discussion. Now, first we are going for AC generator discussion. For this, I need the help of a diagram. That diagram is made in the PDF also. Also, I will draw here, and with the computer diagram, I will explain. So, let's go for that. As you can see, this is the internal structure of AC generator. See, here I am having a permanent magnet. Basically, this magnet is a horseshoe magnet. Means one side north pole, another side
south pole. This magnet has a huge strength. So this side north pole, this side south pole. Now you can see here I am having shaft. Shaft means which I can rotate. If you see carefully, here I am having a handle. So if I can want to rotate it either mechanically or by the help of any machine, that we can do. We know electrical generator means which convert mechanical energy to electrical energy. Means actually mechanical energy is given by this shaft. We are rotating this. So if I rotate this, this coil is called actually this rectangular coil. What you can see, that is called armature. Remember, this rectangular coil is called armature. Here you can see two rings over there. Here one rings, here another ring. That is called slip rings. That is called slip rings. Repeating again, this is permanent magnet. Magnetic field generated by this permanent magnet. Another side of this permanent magnet is a hot shoe. So now here I am having a shaft. By the help of this shaft, I can rotate it. Now here I am having a rectangular coil. Now if you see carefully, one part of the rectangular coil is connected here, another part connected here. Both the parts are not connected in the same terminal. There is a reason. What is that reason? I am telling you afterwards. Now, slip ring, here I am having two terminals. That two terminals are actually called brasses. That two terminals are actually called brasses. One part of the brasses is connected to circuit, another part of the brushes is also connected to the circuit. That circuit I have not drawn here. Actually, the output voltage, what I am getting, I will get from these two terminal. These two terminal, I will get the output voltage from these two terminal. Okay, repeating, this is shaft. By that, I will rotate the coil. Then, this is the armature. Armature means this rectangular coil. These two are called the slip rings. Clear? One part of the coil connected to this slip ring, another part of the coil connected to this slip ring. Now two slip ring has the carbon brushes. That carbon brushes will ultimately give me the supply of the electric energy or alternating voltage. Clear?
Now see, as we know, whenever there is a electromagnetic induction, means by the changing of magnetic field, electricity generates. If you remember the diagram, the diagram was that there is a circuit. Here I am having a galvanometer. And here I am having magnetic field, north pole, south pole. So here I am having a coil. So when a magnet is moving towards the coil or away the coil, magnetic flux induced the coil. So actually what is going on? Changing of magnetic flux. Now think about practically. If you want to move a huge bar magnet. So here I am having a bar magnet. I want to move continuously. Or two things I can do. Either I can move the bar magnet to change the magnetic field intensity or magnetic flux. Or I can shift the coil. Here I am having the coil. I can rotate or I can move this coil. So the number of flux will be changes. So two things might be happen. First thing, I can move this magnet, or secondly, what I can do? I can move this coil to any one I can do. So it is seen that instead of moving this huge bar magnet, it is easy to rotate or move this coil. It is easy to rotate or move this coil. So coil is lighter than the magnet. Okay. So if coil is lighter than the magnet, so the mechanical energy used or the power used to rotate the coil quite less with respect to the power utilized to move the magnet. Clear? That is one thing. So actually, in theoretically, when we are studying electromagnetic induction, there we are saying we are moving this magnet towards the coil or away from the coil. But practically, when we are implementing the thing, electromagnetic induction, actually we are rotating the coil. So if I rotate the coil or move the coil, you can ask me, ma'am, why we are not moving the coil? Why by shaft we are rotating the coil? I saw you the diagram. Why we by shaft, utilizing of shaft, we are rotating the coil? Because if you want to move the coil, you need a huge place. The whole thing should be within a room. So many things. So it's better you include all the things within a machinery. You are rotating the coil. So actually rotating the coil means changing of magnetic field. Changing of magnetic field means generation of electrical field, generation of electromotive force or EMF. If there is a generation of EMF, that is our main motto, main purpose. Okay. So we are going for that AC generator, that complete instrumentational setup. So let's go for the diagram and discuss. Now see, by mechanical energy, when I am rotating the shaft clockwise or anti-clockwise, so this direction I am rotating the coil. So when I am rotating the coil, what is happening? The magnetic flux passes through this coil. Magnetic flux passes through this north pole to south pole will change through which is passes through the coil. Clear? Now, when it is changes, there is a generation of EMF. Clear? Now, when the magnetic armature is just perpendicular, means armature is instead of the here, armature is here in this point. So, the flux passes through this will be the maximum passes of the electrical flux density. So, if maximum passage of electrical flux density, so there is a generation of EMF, clear? Now, there is a generation of EMF. That EMF will passes through here. I will get a voltage drop. Voltage. Now, again, it will be parallel. Then it will be go to the downward portion. When it is again downward portion, again it is perpendicular to the magnetic field. Now, when again it is perpendicular to the magnetic field, again I am getting from this point the next half of my AC voltage. Next half of my AC voltage. That's why two terminal of the coil, means this terminal and this terminal, both the two terminals are connected not on the same point. Because if it is connected on the same point, we will get either positive half of the cycle or negative half of the cycle. Be clear about that. We will get either positive half of the cycle or negative half of the cycle. Now, since the both the terminals connected into two different points, so first half we are getting from here, second half we are getting from this terminal. First half, second half, first half, second half. This is the AC. So actually it is very easy to understand that the whenever the coil is rotating, the coil is actually, the coil is direction of motion of the coil is perpendicular to the magnetic flux. We know Fleming's rule. Now if direction of the magnetic field is perpendicular to the direction of the armature coil or motion of the coil is perpendicular with the magnetic field, so it is obvious that there is a generation of current. That current will be along the perpendicular direction. So obviously if the coil is here, clear, means this is perpendicular to the magnetic field, so there is a, on that perpendicular basis, there is a generation of current either through this terminal or through this terminal, and we are getting two part of the voltage. We are getting two part of the voltage. As you see, I have drawn the same things here. Here I am having the north pole to south pole. So, flux is passes like this through the coil, clear? Now, what is happening? The coil is exactly parallel to the flux density, clear? Now, next half, when it start rotating, coil is here. Coil looks like this. perpendicular. So direction of the coin is perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field intensity or flux. So obviously either here or here I will get a EMF or a flux, electricity. So this is the first term. Clear? Now again third position, it will again parallel rotation. Clear? Like this. It was first like this, then like this, then again like this. So it is rotating again like this. So here I will not get any current. Again when it is downward portion, right now it is like this. So downward portion means again if this direction is perpendicular to this, I will get my second half. So by that continuous, it is happening so fast, we are getting continuous AC current changing with the direction. AC current, first term, second term, first term, second term. Actually, there is a rotation of the coil inside the magnetic field. That is all about AC generator. In my next video, I am going for the DC generator. And one more thing, in my PDF, diagram given, detailed discussion given. Thank you.